players. Will you please welcome from Greece? He represented his home country 5 times at the World Cup of Darts. He is Deadly Rose, John Michael! Legend, a former world master and a former lakeside champion of the world, the one and only, the bronze medalist, Steve Beaton!
Oh, just drink it in.
Look at it. Late night Beaton on a Friday. Hungary, this is what darts is all about. The bronzed Adonis. Steve Beaton, former champion of the world.
Taking on the Deadly Rose, the record-breaking, history-making 16-time champion of Greece, John Michael. Only one man can make it through to the second round, where the number 6 seed this weekend, Michael Smith, awaits. Can Steve Beaton conjure up one of those bronzed Adonis weekends where seemingly out of nowhere just burst through the pack to reach a semi or a final, or maybe even win the whole thing, and suddenly his year changes and the sort of slight slide that we've seen from Beaton is arrested, and he gets in things like the European Championship or the Grand Slam and all this sort of stuff. Because if he doesn't have one of those Beaton weekends at some point soon,
first game on.
One of the ever-presents, seemingly, may just be fading a little. We shall see. I don't like to speak such words. Paul Nicholson sat alongside me. It is the Greek number one versus the Greek gods in Budapest.
You mentioned the European Championship when it comes to Steve Beaton. Well, it's largely forgotten that he's made the final of that
tournament.
How'd the final go?
Not well, no, but then again, I mean, he was up against Taylor playing the greatest tournament in the history of all time.
Absolutely. I wrote an article about that recently and how there's no footage of it because it wasn't on TV. Heartbreaking, really, considering some of the stats that Phil put in, who averaged 110 for the tournament.
I don't believe it. One on telly. I don't believe it. I think you all made it up. I wasn't there. Prove it.
I was there.
I'm a Phil Taylor Euro Championship truther. I don't believe any of it.
46.
You're saying you're a Euro skeptic.
Right, look, anyway, you carry on. I've got to go and take this horse medicine. I'll be back in a couple of minutes.
59.
Well, that was 2009. In Hoofddorp, outside of Amsterdam, where Beaton made that final. Did indeed get his
41.
Revenge by beating Phil in the Grand Slam. But you're right, Steve Beaton needs to do something, I think, before the end of the year to arrest this little slide down the rankings. But I would never, ever back against him doing something, because that throw is still silky smooth. He still believes, he still enjoys the game. And when they are still around, things are possible.
Yeah, and he's done it so many times before, where you think, oh, do you fear for Beaton.
85.
He's had a good month and made a couple of semi-finals, and all of a sudden, he's looking great again. But he wasn't at the match play, was he, for the first time in years.
135.
It can get harder and harder. Double 80.
Game of throw. First leg. Steve Beaton.
Beaton gets on the ball.
Very good.
Second leg. Steve
that
to
fourth
the
shot from the good player was fabulous to leave 36. And Steve Beaton got there first. He takes it with no bother, and he made that 87 look so simple. It's no wonder we still love the way that Steve plays. At his age, he can easily retire with his wife Nanette and just enjoy the beaches, enjoy his motorbike, enjoy the life he has carved out for himself. Not finished yet. And John Michael, who has decided to diversify his darting businesses, not just a player but a retailer, he's not finished either, and he's someone who has played at the European Championships as well.
Yeah, he's top level, he's very, very dangerous. We've not seen perhaps as much of it, and I'll be honest, when he's playing some really good stuff, some of the best stuff I've seen, he couldn't get sponsors. It was too expensive to come over from Greece and play the Pro Tour. He was having all kinds of problems, but double five. We'll give him another problem for Steve Beaton. The shot out for the traps like a sexy greyhound.
John Michael has got a lot on his plate here. But when Beaton's in this kind of mood, he can go a little bit bananas.
125.
Don't really know how to describe that dot. That was a very good five.
Yeah.
44.
Well, they have met, but it was 10 years ago, and it was in Germany at a tournament with a slightly different format to this, because it was pre-Euro Tour. Mm-hmm. It's where they used to play Players' Championships in places like Benidorm and Germany and
100.
Some other places around Europe. Play a lot of the stuff on the floor, and matches were picked out and put on the stage, but 80. They play the semi-finals and the final on the stage. In that tournament, it was John Michael versus Steve Beaton. It was a Beaton victory.
139.
I posed the question to you, didn't I, before we started? Who won that tournament? 10 years ago, it was in October of 2011, and it was his last
45.
Tournament.
Johnny McGuire, 78.
Well, I know the answer, but I'll tell you what, we'll give it you at the end of this leg, viewer.
Game shot
on
the third leg.
John Michael pinning tops to get in the game.
Top leg, Steve, to
his first leg on the board. It is just a whole throw. The winner of that tournament was, of course, the wizard Colin Osborne. He's back playing a bit of darts. Focus League, isn't he? Playing some all right stuff, I think.
Yes, he has. A very different throw for Colin these days.
Is it really?
To almost recraft something that works. But knowing Colin as I do, when he puts his mind to something, he can do marvellous things. And seeing him play good darts, boy, does that bring a smile to your face. I would love to see him back. And I want to see Steve Beaton have more cracks at tournaments, because it's still there and it's still brilliant.
81.
Tell you one thing I did very recently as well.
46.
I had a spare afternoon, and I thought I would re-watch Steve Beaton's World Championship winning final against Richie Burnett.
180.
I almost forgot just how well he played in that tournament. He was averaging more than five more than Burnett going into the final, and yet Burnett was the favourite. Didn't turn out that way, did it? As John Michael goes for 280 in six. And gets it! John Michael with some quality!
12 data.
Fifth leg, John Michael.
Two down, now two all. Beaton 98 average. John Michael 102.6. And this is sort of, I don't want to say the best of John Michael, but it's certainly right up there with the best we've seen on big stages from him. It's good.
46.
Very experienced. Not just playing in his part of Europe, but he's gone around a bit. Tried a few different things. And this one is starting. So it's very, 30 kilometers, 50 seconds, but for some reason it feels like he's hit more.
97.
He's had 7 2 treble visits already in this match. Only in leg 5. Only seen one dart at double missed in the entire match. That was
45.
Followed by hitting the double of the very next dart in the same visit by John Michael. I mean, it's almost been a match free of mistakes.
96.
He keeps getting that first dart in, just like that.
100.
The rest of this match is going to feel very much easier. I've said it so many times, when you get the first dart in, it takes pressure off the next two.
Johnny,
you can be so aggressive with the next two. Seen a 130 checkout already from Steve Beaton. I'm not going to get one.
58.
John
Michael, see if you require 164.
Bring the house down.
Johnny requires 72.
John Michael looking to make it 3 legs on the spin. Not what he was after either, so it's going to be 13 and ball. Oh, lovely. Double 12.
60.
You're almost shocked to see someone miss a double in this match.
Just will punish, but not going to happen.
The old John Law route.
91.
51
first. Johnny require 12.
John Michael for the lead after being 2-0 down. Double 3. Can use that flight.
6.
But couldn't guide it over
Steve
the top. That's why
50.
He was gesticulating with his right arm there. Tops for Beaton. What a chance. What a bonus.
Game
what a
kick
from Beaton,
Steve Beaton.
Who should be 3-2 down, but now the rules
six
are reversed with that breaker throw.
Game off.
4 darts missed by John Michael, who shakes his head because there was a little spell of a few minutes there where he's in complete control of that game. And he's just squirmed away from it.
Interesting qualification for Steve Beaton because he came through the very dangerous Karol Sedlacek from Czech Republic.
58.
But he also came through against Ian White, who I suppose going into the qualifiers was really hoping to come through, but you had any word about Ian White's operation?
From what I was led to believe, I think he's either had it or he's having it, because obviously he's not involved here. He's not involved in Gibraltar, so he won't be at the European Championship. He's not at, say, the World Series event, so it's basically got fair time to get it done, get over. And hopefully it sorts it all out and he can get back to his very best. We know when he's at his very best, he's one of the very best.
What a great lead from John Michael.
Beaton-esque.
I was just about to say that. Steve needs 85.
66.
And he has not missed a dart at a double yet in this match, so you would assume that if that continues, 4-2 it will be. And
well,
this match will
really
be
get annoyed about leaving a bogey number when you've got two big travels.
He's only got himself to blame.
Yeah, well, that's very true.
And we still haven't missed a double with Beaton. But you are absolutely right, Dan. If you've left 1-6-3, it doesn't really matter what you do if your opponent's sitting on tops. You can hit a 1-3-1, you can hit a 1-2-3. The fault lies in the previous visit.
60.
The frustration is just compounded, isn't it? Stick two in the treble and think, oh, could have had a dart or something. Well, look at that, 0.01 between them for that little moment there. But it's the finishing that has proved to be the difference. 4 darts missed in doubles by John Michael in that fifth leg. So he went 3-2 down instead of 3-2 up.
I'm sure John Michael's in your bad books because he took out Andrew Gilding on the way here.
Well, hey, look. A lot of time for John Michael. And, hey, you know what? He's if we're looking for a
100.
Impressive specs wearer in the field, then another one in John Michael. A good call.
John Michael also took out Callan Ridds on the way to getting 100. To this point.
No mean feat this year. Callan Ridds, a title winner, and obviously had that run to the quarterfinals of the World Match Play as well in his debut.
Actually, I had a text from Callum Ritz today. 5th maximum of this match, 3rd from John. As Callum texted me and said he was playing Super League last night. Guess who he was playing against?
100.
Ryan Joyce.
Chris Dolby.
Oh, it's like he was one of them, wasn't it?
Double 10 for John Michael. This is a key shot. Just for his confidence. Probably would have got another visit. But the fact of the matter is, you've got to take care of those types of things. Leave yourself on the right numbers, John.
Well,
55.
The number one from Greece is the heaviest scorer in this game. Steve Beaton is finishing flawlessly. Which one will prevail?
140.
Going along at a really good pace, isn't it? And no matter who comes through this, it will be a good pace in round two because Michael Smith awaits.
Michael, I mean,
177.
Could be hypnotic, couldn't it? But the way that John is rattling through, it could be a good watch as well.
140.
I like the way that John plays the game. He doesn't mess around.
Don't hit a ton, Steve. Don't hit a ton. He's moving down the ball. 99. There we go.
Yeah, but he still went the wrong way.
Oh, yeah, I mean, obviously. He did. But,
I mean, 19's on dart 2 or dart 1. And at least to give yourself a chance with the last dart. That's the feeling. But this might not fail. I was waiting for a shot of the ball there.
105.
Johnny
McGuire, 161.
Can he?
No.
Should go 25 here. I guess 60. 20 anyway.
Steve McGuire, 65.
Beaton looks for tops again. This is for the first time.
55.
That's 2.
Johnny McGuire, 101.
First time he's offered up an opportunity in that manner. 12 or 4, where are we looking? Double 16.
Top plus check out John Michael. Look at the celebration there.
Sensational finish that.
Considering
Steve Beaton, for the very first time in the match, has missed one and then his second dart at a double. He has now been reeled in. There have been periods in this match. 2 for Steve, 2 for John. 2 for Steve, 2 for John.
43.
So if that continues, Beaton wins 6-4.
Well, let's see. Beaton's perfect record on the doubles.
140.
It's been not ruined, but dented. Just give John Mike a little bit of hope. It must be so frustrating to be feel like you're outscoring your opponent, but they're literally taking out every single double they're going for. They're just not giving you any opportunity.
As far as a scoring game is concerned, that's very impressive for John Michael.
Well, it is. And yet the first 9 average is still just below a tie. You'd expect, wouldn't you, 3 180s, 13-2 treble visits. Earning the 9th leg, he'd be another 10 points on the first 9 average, but it's just a curious set of stats that we've got there.
Yeah, he's just put another one on that stat as well. It says to me that maybe he's having those two troubles
60.
Either side of a real poor visit.
Yeah, and you can see there that 2-ton plus checkouts is John Michael. He has saved some of his best stuff at the end of legs.
139.
That 101 in particular.
Speak about needing things. I think Beaton needs a maximum here.
Oh, yeah.
Whee! Just like that.
But it could be.
Because John Michael, for 5-4,
is in.
What a great game of darts this is. John Michael, absolutely. And the quality you have brought against a very good Steve Beaton tonight.
Wow. Steve Beaton needs to hold his throw to force a last leg decider for the third time tonight. The two previous occasions we have seen missed match darts before somebody's been knocked out of the tournament. Happened to Jake Jones, it just happened to Adrian Lewis. Could it happen to one of these two? John Michael wants to get it done right now.
Are we seeing some 42. Of the players who are playing World Cup next week really starting to get their teeth into these kinds of games today? John Michael playing for Greece. Could be a handful. That is his 4th maximum of this match.
100.
Look down Steve Beaton's stats. He's averaging 95, 3 180s, 67% on doubles, and you think that's a winning formula.
60.
Not tonight, judging by what John's doing. 99 for him, more 180s. He's got 4. He's got 45% on the doubles, which is just about enough. Beaton leaves 165.
It's 140 to leave 165 in a leg that you have to win.
65.
Okay. Do you get much benefit with the bullseye?
Nope. None at all. 133 needed. Gets it.
133.
Huge. Let's find out how good your finishing can be, John. Because that 25 leaving 136 does give you two at the same treble. I'll give you that. But you don't get the first one, and you offer Steve Beaton a little chance. He likes 32 as well.
Steve, you require 32.
Take us all the way. The game deserves it for me. Good guide, that. Superb from Steve Beaton.
Steve Beaton.
10 legs, and we are level. John Michael has the darts. Can he be broken in the last leg? Steve Beaton, who will be in Gibraltar, he's looking to get a spot at the Europeans once again.
96.
Amazed that Steve Beaton has not been sponsored by
96.
One of those really famous washing powders, because every single time he wears this white shirt, I've never seen such a glorious white garment.
It is whiter than white.
100.
Young and aspiring dart players, if you want to look nice on the hockey, make sure your
60.
Shirt is fully ironed. Yes, I'm talking to you, Kirk Shepherd.
Hey, look, I mean, yeah, you can look nice, but whatever you aspire to, you're not going to look as good as Steve Beaton. That's just a fact. Get over it. John Michael with the 180. And he's going to get match darts from here, or should do. 5 maximums for John Michael in 11 legs. 4-2 down, he has put on the afterburners, a bit like Adrian Lewis did.
85.
Jackpot couldn't get the job done. Can John Michael get the job done? He's going to get match darts here. Jake Jones missed 4. Adrian Lewis missed a couple of handfuls. Hits the maximum to apply the pressure and ask the question, does the Deadly Rose have the answer?
I think John Michael was uttering that famous saying of Mervyn King's there. Go away! Double 10 will put him away.
Get
and it does! A top class match between these two.
Unfortunately for everyone, Steve Beaton is eliminated.
John Michael, that has to be one of the best performances you've put in your career in the PDC. A 99 average. Maximums for him. What a performance, and he's going to take on Michael Smith, the number 6 seed, in the next round tomorrow. That will fill him full of confidence. He will have a chance tomorrow, the Deadly Rose, to make the Sunday in the European Tour for the very first time in his life. Don't go anywhere. We've got more where that came from, because Darren Webster, the Demolition Man, is about to take on the Wizard, Simon Whitlock.
Into the second round, John Michael. John, that was really, really hard work against one of the legends of the game with Steve Beaton.
Thanks. First, and Steve is a good player. I know him. I'm his favorite player before a long time ago. I'm starting the darts, and I don't have any word to say that. I think I play well. And I hope in the next round I play the same.
I mean, those fans, they were supporting you in a great way as well.
Yeah, thanks to my supporters. I don't know who is the girl. Say, come on, John, please. Is you? Yeah, I give you one set of my flights. I love it. I will come back from 2 years to play again to Europe, and I'm so happy because I love it. These people, I love the European, I love all.
Ladies and gentlemen, we love to see you play into the second round. Deadly Rose, John Michael. And we'll be back with the next cracking match.